Do you find the subject of atmospheric stability confusing? Let's fix that. Wave, thermal, and convergence lift all depend on the atmospheric stability at the time. Your ability to understand atmospheric stability will allow you to know whether it's a day to work at home or cancel everything and head to the glider port. It's also a topic for discussion on any glider check ride. When we talk about atmospheric stability, we're talking about what happens when a volume or parcel of air is moved within the static atmosphere. First, let's define what we mean by stability or instability. An example often used is a marble on a surface. If the marble is in a bowl, it's a stable or positively stable situation. If we displace the marble, it will eventually find its way back to where it started. We can move it, and it will take a couple of swings to get there, but we will eventually settle down to where it began. If the marble is on a flat surface, it's neutrally stable. If we displace it, it will keep going, but will neither speed up nor slow down. If the marble is on a slanted surface, it is unstable or has negative stability. Here, it doesn't even need a push, and it will accelerate away faster and faster. If the marble sits on an odd shape like this, it's conditionally unstable. That is, it's stable or neutrally stable unless it gets a big enough push, and then it becomes unstable. We can have similar situations in the atmosphere. In the same way that the stability of the marble is not so much dependent on the marble, but the environment that it operates in, so too the atmospheric stability is a property of the environmental temperature gradient within a given altitude range. Our marble will be the parcel of air. In a stable atmosphere, if a parcel of air gets pushed up or down, it will try to return to its starting place, its original altitude. This is what happens with mountain wave. In an unstable atmosphere, that parcel of air will accelerate away from a starting point. This is what happens when a towering cumulus develops and forms a thunderstorm. A key factor is the parcel's temperature change with altitude. When it's moved up, it will expand. Its energy now distributed among a larger space, so its temperature will go down. And the same in reverse. If it's moved down, it will compress, and its energy will be in a smaller space, increasing its temperature. This effect of temperature change due to air expanding or compressing is called adiabatic. The rate at which the temperature changes with altitude is called the adiabatic lapse rate, and when we plot it, the line is called an adiabat. This temperature change works for unsaturated air, that is, not in a cloud, in both directions, at the same rate, that is, 3 degrees Celsius or 5.4 degrees Fahrenheit per 1,000 feet. This is the dry adiabatic lapse rate. If we raise a parcel of air 1,000 feet, it will cool by about 3 degrees Celsius. And if we lower that same parcel of air by 1,000 feet, it will warm by the same 3 degrees. It can work for moist air too, as long as the droplets don't form precipitation in the meantime. The moist adiabatic lapse rate varies with temperature and ranges from about the same as the dry adiabatic rate of 3 degrees per 1,000 feet in very cold conditions to about 1 degree Celsius per 1,000 feet in warm conditions. To determine where the atmosphere is going to be on this stability scale, we need to plot two different temperature trends on an adiabatic lapse rate chart, or Skew-T chart, where altitude is on the vertical axis and temperature is on the horizontal. The environmental temperature at each altitude, and the temperature of the parcel of air that's going to be displaced. The chart has lines that show the adiabatic lapse rates. We can plot the temperature of our parcel by drawing a line parallel to the adiabatic lapse rate lines. So what we need to do now is to displace the air in altitude and see how its new temperature compares to the temperature of the air around it at the new altitude. In the situation of mountain wave, the air first flows down the downwind or lee side of the mountain where it compresses. It follows the dry adiabat. We can see that it becomes warmer than the surrounding air, so it will rise. It's got some mass and inertia, so it's going to overshoot the point where it's the same temperature as the surrounding air. Now up here, it's colder than the surrounding air and will turn around and sink. Overshoot a bit and repeat the cycle following the dry adiabat. This bouncing back and forth is what causes the waves to form. if the rising air parcel maintains the same temperature differential as the changes with altitude, it will keep going at about the same vertical speed. As long as that temperature difference exists, it is neutrally stable. And if it's warmer than the surrounding air by more than it was when it started, it's going to keep rising and speeding up in the process. In this case, it is unstable. Now, the air can go from being approximately neutrally stable to unstable by having a cloud form. This is conditional instability. If the rising air cools to its dew point, a cloud will start to form. Now, just as it takes heat to turn liquid water into vapor, you get that same heat back when the vapor condenses back into liquid droplets. That additional heat makes the parcel now moist air cool slower, thus giving us the moist adiabatic lapse rate. Now, eventually, we run out of water vapor molecules to give up their heat, and the moist adiabat ends up approaching the dry adiabat when no more heat is being released into the parcel of air. And then it only changes temperature at the dry adiabatic lapse rate. If the moist adiabatic lapse rate continues to make the temperature differential within the surrounding air increase, then the cloud will build rapidly and may eventually form a thunderstorm. So what we can learn from this is that if the environmental lapse rate is greater than or leans to the left of the dry adiabat, the atmosphere is unstable. If the environmental lapse rate is between the dry and moist adiabats, it's considered conditionally unstable. That is, when dry, it acts stable, but if a cloud forms in the process, it can become unstable due to the cooling rate of the moist adiabat. And if the environmental lapse rate is less than or to the right of the moist adiabat, it is absolutely stable. Hey, thanks for watching. Comments are really appreciated, and please subscribe to help promote the channel and know when new content is posted. I've linked some additional materials for further reading in the description. For additional information on the Skew-T chart, you can see my video on that here.